Mission alert. Special training for all ARCS ops is underway. Report to the quest counter to join the mission.
Did you bring a bunch? I hope you'll bring more next time.
Come again!
Well, hello there.
Come on in. Come back any old
Welcome.
Time.
Please
Need
come
something?
Again.
Thank you.
Leaving already?
Welcome.
Please come again.
Well, come on in. Come back any old time.
Thank you.
What quest are you up for?
Eska Falspun are a total mess, aren't they?
Indeed. We have many things that need doing, but ignoring that issue is out of the question. The Eska Falspun are dangerous, even more dangerous than the ordinary Falspun.
I don't think we can ignore either problem, to be honest. Are the Eska Falspun really such a threat?
Stronger than Falspun. The fusion of ether and photons has given them strength we've not encountered up to this point. And they're under our enemy's control. They can also manifest anywhere thanks to their roots as phantasms. So you're right that we can't ignore either threat. But one of them is more pressing at the moment.
The Eska Falspun.
It's Ark's job to deal with Falspun, so we'll fight them wherever they are. But when our forces are insufficient...
You can count on us! Of course! We'll use our powers to protect everyone! Oh, it's you. I'm totally okay now, see? I'm fine, honestly. I didn't have any major injuries, and I'm totally okay now. I was just thinking a little about Corey. Corey wasn't good at anything. Bad at sports. School, totally out of step with everything. Even when things were tough, she'd still have this gentle smile, like she was somehow happy. I first met her after we started high school. It was through Mother Corps that we met. To be honest, at first, I just kind of wrote her off as this dim-witted kid. She was always following me around, so at first, I just kind of saw her as an annoyance. So, I treated her coldly at first. And yet, she didn't shy away. Whenever she saw me, she'd come running like a puppy. I wonder when it was. The two of us joined student council. And Cory, she got bullied a little. People would hide her things or mess with her desk. It went on for a while. And even then, she was always smiling. She always smiled like she was enjoying herself. Even though I was the reason she was getting bullied, that smile was always on her face. You see, originally, I was being bullied. Cory saw people were teasing me because I was spirited, so she stopped them, and they came after her instead. I had no idea. I just kept thinking she was annoying. And then one day, I ran into her being bullied. But she looked at me and smiled. Cory just smiled, as she always did. I realized that smile of hers was a sign that she was fighting an impossible battle inside. It was a sign that she was struggling, that she wanted help. Until then, I had no idea. And so I clenched my fists and went for... The teacher caught us and we were punished. Not exactly a happily ever. After that, Cory stuck even closer. And I accepted her. When we saw her early, she was laughing the same way she did then. I know that laugh. She laughs that way when she needs help. It's just like it was back then. She's suffering because she wants to help me. So that's why I need to save her. Ouch! Sorry. You're right. I don't need to save her. We do.
Hello! Oh, you're with Hitsuki. Oh, my. I'm not interrupting something, am I?
Come on, Sierra. Don't tease us.
Just a little joke. And now that you're back and relaxed, you and Enga are like two peas in a pod. The similarity is uncanny.
What? I'm too young to be jaded. It's my junior year. I've got dumb kid time left.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about that.
What are you doing there, Enga?
Don't worry about it. Yo, Sierra, I thought we were in a hurry. What gives?
Oh, yes, we are. We've picked up Eska Falsbond readings.
Again? Where?
I'm verifying the coordinates now. They're at Celestia Academy. That's Hitsuki's school.
The large-scale operation has ended. thank you for your support.
I'm at school? How did I get here? Wait. There's nothing weird about this. I'm a high school student after all. I go here. Feel snuck and lonely. I wonder why. Doesn't it feel that way for you too? Hitsuki? Huh? Hitsuki? Oh, right. I came here because Mother wanted me to. Right. And she told me that Hitsuki would show up if I caused any trouble. Hitsuki and I spent our days together at this school. This is our place to return to. She will come here to protect it. I will destroy it? I'll destroy it? But why would I hurt the place where I spent my days with Hitsuki? To get her back? To save her? I have to destroy our special place to do that? Why? Why? You can't do this, Kouri! Listen to yourself! Hitsuki and I made all of our memories here. We studied together, played sports together, laughed, got angry, cried. Together. Always together. I can't. I won't. I would never! This place, this school, this is where Hitsuki and I belong. I won't let anyone destroy it, ever!
Get rid of these things and protect our school first!
Yeah, let's do it!
We'll be right back.
our school. I was trying to destroy our home. I don't know why. I didn't want to. But it felt like it was the only way to get you back. And then...
We protected it, though. We were okay, because you helped.
Yeah, you're right.
Corey? What's wrong, Corey? Corey!
How troublesome. You really shouldn't interfere with someone else's patient.
Stop! Stay out of me! No! 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 Stop! Stop! I don't want to fight! I don't want to fight Hitsugi!
I have no other choice, though. This is for Mother. If I don't kill Hitsugi, she won't come back. And Mother won't be happy. All right! Time to die, Hitsugi! You'll come back to me! If you die!
You... people. Just how rotten are you?
Give Hitsugi back. Give her back. Give her back. Give her back. More power.
Your Majesty, code to you.
No.
Completed!
Hitsugi! We're not done yet! Hitsugi! Just stand down, Corey! If we keep fighting, there's no telling what will happen to you! I can't, Hitsugi. I have to save you. And Mother ordered me to kill you, okay?
Her vital signs are abnormal. Her body is overloaded. She should be in incredible pain.
Corey!
Fall back, Hitsugi. You shouldn't have to do this. I'll take care of her.
No. It's been my mistake from the start for not facing her properly. So... I'll set things right. I will be the one to strike Corey down.
Just quit your moping, okay? I don't want to see your face so troubled. Shake it off. I was always alone before you. You were my first friend. The first person who was important. I want to be together always. Forever. No matter what happens, Hitsugi.
Let me go! I have to deal with Corey! Take it! will only suffer more. You're still telling me not to give up?
Of course they would.
Probably would be faster to just take her down. But man, that wouldn't be right. Yo, Hitsugi, you want to save Al too, don't you? Hurry and save Corey then. Use your power and make your dreams a reality.
Inga! Thank you. Right now! Corey! Hitsugi? Hitsugi? Hitsugi! I'm so glad we're together! I'm so, so sorry. I was so afraid. I thought you hated me. We were always together. And then we weren't. And then... I'm sorry, Corey. I'm sorry for leaving you alone. You didn't do anything wrong, Corey. It was my fault. It was my fault for how I treated you. I should have told you everything. We should have talked more. My worries and hurts your worries and your hurts. We should have confronted those things head on. I'm a real failure as a friend, aren't I? It's okay with you. Why don't we start over one more time? Go back to how things were when we first met.
Hitsugi!
all the barging in and undoing my procedure? You cut the ether without harming the body? According to legend, it has the power of purification. I never would have thought that it would manifest as this. It appears the ether responded to her feelings. Her desire was so powerful, overwhelming, to save Kori Washinomiya and the hybrid.
My, what an unexpected and lovely response. I had fully intended to kill you.
Feilig! What is your intent?
Didn't I say to kill you?
I'm asking you, why?
You have a detestable scent. The scent of someone arrogant and foolish enough to believe he should control others. Your scent is not like those of Mother or of Arcs, and I find it most repugnant. He got away. Well, no matter. I can kill him at any time. You seem to be developing quite well. I can hardly wait for my chance to see you at full power.
That menacing attitude from before go.
Everyone, can you hear me?
Sierra? What's up? You look like you just saw a ghost.
We'll talk about it later, but just look at the sky! Look at the sky! At the moon!
The moon? What the... The moon... is changing color!
Thank you.
Give Hitsugi back! Give her back! Give her back! Oh, I am gonna cut you!
Emergency! Code! You! Mm-hmm.
You're not even trying, huh?
Here you go! Cool.
Wait up! Look down! Mm-hmm. Oh, I am gonna cut you! Hmm? You're not even trying, huh? Give me more power! You're not even trying, huh?
All the barging in and undoing my procedure? You cut the ether without harming the body? According to legend, it has the power of purification. I never would have thought that it would manifest as this. It appears the ether responded to her feelings. Her desire was so powerful, overwhelming, to save Cory Washinomiya and the hybrid.
Oh! My, what an unexpected and lovely response. I had fully intended to kill you.
Failing! What is your intent?
Didn't I say?
I'm asking you, what?
Oh. These Eska Fallspawn are a total mess, aren't they?
Indeed. We have many things that need doing, but ignoring that issue is out of the question.
The Eska Fallspawn are dangerous, even more dangerous.
I don't think we can ignore them.
Yeah. Welcome. Thank you very much. What do you need? Thank you. You'll have to excuse me.
Welcome to our shop. I'm here if you need me.
What would you like to do? Feel free to stop by anytime.
Thank you.
about everything.
Thank you.
What quest are you up for?
Mother! Where are you? So they are issuing forth even here. Well, I can only suppose that it is because they are phantasms that they are appearing here. This place is where Mother is, making it the source of ether. You don't lack for numbers, but I've not the time to deal with you. Mother, what the blazes was that?
Rather than letting them run amok, I will absorb them into this body and put them to use. It is my only choice.
That seems like it would cause a great deal of strain. Can your body hold that much?
Your concerns are unfounded. More pressing, you had some business with me, Aratron.
Yes. I bring news. Ill news, I fear. Kore Washinomiya has regained her own consciousness. She has left us. Further, Ophiel has not returned. Whether that is because he has forsaken us, or... What it means is that ultimately, you and I are the ones who remain.
I see. You do well to depart, Aratron. I see no reason for you to remain by my side any longer.
Put your mind at ease, Mother. I am with you. I will not leave you. I promised as much. Being with you reminds me of when we first met, when we came to research the moon. You showed me new prospects, and I resolved to follow you. I feel the same now. My decision remains unchanged. You are the one who showed this withered old man that there are dazzling possibilities. Nothing will change that, Mother.
Even if what I do is, put crudely, bad.
I was the one who woke you, yes? 12 years ago, as I worked on moon development, I roused you from slumber. Thus, no matter what you try to achieve, it is my duty to see it through. I suppose you might call it responsibility, whether your objectives serve good or ill. And it will be up to history to decide whichever it may be. It is that simple. We each act according to our own aspirations. Mine is to watch over you and see you to your destination. Follow your heart, and follow your intuition, to achieve what you will, Mother. For that, I will bring my strength to bear.
How sentimental of you.
To me, that is quite the compliment.
We are approaching the finale. We cannot afford even one false move now. To achieve the next stage in human evolution and development, and to create something new, I must also act.